Welcome back to Kids Fun Science. My name's Ken. Today's experiment is the balloon lung. As always, adult supervision is required. What you need for this experiment is a glue gun, balloons, scissors, bottle, straw, and rubber bands. To set up this experiment, you need to take your plastic bottle with an adult supervision and cut the bottom off the bottle. I'm using an X-Acto knife here, which could be dangerous, so take your time and have an adult help you take the bottom off. You could also use scissors to remove that bottom part of the bottle. When you're finished cutting the bottom off, it should look like this. Next step, take your straws and your rubber bands and your balloons. I have bendy straws that seem to keep the balloons away from each other. Put your balloon on and then take your rubber band and wrap it around so it's securely tight so no air can escape the balloon. So you do about 3 or 4 times around and it will securely hold that balloon onto the straw like so. And then we're going to do the second straw, same thing. And so we have both straws together. So now you should have both straws done. Bend out the twisty part of the bendy straws, and the rubber bands are on secure. Then we're going to cut off a portion of the straw. Depending on how large your bottle is, will determine how low you want to cut the straws. They want to be able to hang about halfway down. So once you get the cut in, then you're going to tape the straws together so the bendy straws are facing out like a Y. I did one piece of tape towards the bottom. And then I'll come back and do one more piece of tape here on the top, holding the straws in place when we get ready to put it into the bottle. Now I just took a little bit of a welding tool here. I'm going to melt the cap just the size of 2 straws. You could also take scissors or a drill to go through. This seemed to work pretty easy. Make sure you have an adult helping you. It gets extremely hot. So I kind of played around a little bit. I would do it a little bit and then check the straw sizes to make sure they fit in. So you don't want it too big. It can go a little bit big, but you want to make it just right so the straws fit in. Once you have that done, then you slide the straws from the bottom part of the bottle that you cut a hole in. And then you take your cap that you pre-cut a hole in or soldered a hole in and squeeze both the straws through that. And once you get that through, you slide down the cap. You only want a little bit sticking out, and you kind of gauge it to how low the straws will be. Then screw on the cap, and then to seal the top part of the cap, I used a glue gun. Make sure you just seal off the top part. You don't want any air getting out of the bottle. So go ahead and glue that there and let it dry. Remember, the hot glue gun gets very hot, so have adults help you if you need it. Then for the last part, you just take a balloon. I have a 12-inch balloon here, and you cut it off just about where it starts to get big. So just take your scissors very carefully and cut that off. That's going to be the bottom part of your bottle. It helps to have a second person here. It was a little bit harder putting it on by yourself, but you're able to do it. Just believe in yourself. You can do it. And then you're set, and you have it. Your experiment's ready to go now. So you have a balloon's lung. The way this experiment works is you just grab the bottom part of the latex, the balloon, and pull down and it inflates the lungs. This is how our lungs operate inside our bodies. The base of our lungs is a membrane called the diaphragm. When you breathe, this diaphragm contracts and expands. When you inhale, your diaphragm contracts to make room for your lungs, which will fill up with air the way the balloon does when you blow it up. This demonstrates the action when you pull down on the latex bottom, as I said earlier. When you exhale, your diaphragm expands, forcing the air out of your lungs, which you can see in the action using the model here when you push up on the latex balloon. Muscles in your rib cage, which protect your lungs, are also used in the respiration, allowing your lungs to fill up with air. The main purpose of the respiration is the intake of air, which contains oxygen, an element vital to our survival, and a removal of the waste product, the carbon dioxide. So if you were running and pulled the up and down the latex very quickly, you'd be able to see how your lungs would be expanding and contracting as they need to take in more oxygen. This is a really easy experiment to put together. Most of these household items you have. I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to click thumbs up and to subscribe. Thanks for watching.